invited by our local center, the Hare Krishna Center here in Mongolia, to come and share my experiences as a traveling monk around the world. I'm giving classes on this ancient scripture from India called the Bhagavad Gita, spoken by Lord Krishna 5,000 years ago. I was very pleased when I came here and I visited various Buddhist monasteries and had discussions with the lamas and the monks. I noticed that chanting mantras is central to both of our practices. And whereas in Buddhism, you sit and chant silently, or you chant with the other monks, sitting down in a peaceful environment. Our tradition, we stand, we sing, and we dance as we chant our mantras at the same time. This is that. Our mantras, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. I find that Mongolian people are extremely pious. I attribute this to the fact that they've retained their original traditions of the country, including their religious beliefs in Buddhism, especially in the countryside. Many countries in the world now, I feel that the material progress, which of course has so many benefits, speaking on a television to millions of people. At the same time, it brings bad habits as well. There's a lot of alcoholism, there's a lot of drug addiction, illicit, promiscuous sexual activities, there's corruption, coming from the West as well. And I see that's also in some ways affecting the country. So how to maintain our original, the beautiful culture of Mongolia, the original culture with the spirituality, while at the same time embracing material progress. Both are important. How to keep the balance. Like Buddha said, the middle way, material progress and spiritual progress side by side. So the spirituality is a little bit in decline here, unfortunately. Many of the youth are forgetting and they're fascinated by Western culture. So I think we can help remind them of the beauty of Mongolian culture, and especially the spiritual culture. We can help in our humble way.
And sometimes people, they become agitated in the mind, they become depressed, stressed in the mind, and for this they become more aggressive to the society. And for this, what can be the solution for them?
The bad effect of material progress. There's many benefits from material progress, but one bad effect is the stress and the anxiety that brings people. I see it all over the world. Just to sit in the traffic, to get to work or go shopping, there's so much stress. The traffic is horrendous. So people deal with this in an artificial way. They take drugs, they take intoxication, they engage in bad habits and things like this. But this is not the way to deal with these problems. It complicates things.
So then how can we get rid of this stress?
Well, again, there's a motto in India, simple living with high thinking. Not we make our lives so complicated, there's now time to think about the deeper issues of life. Who am I? Where have I come from? What happens at death? So that simple living you see in the countryside, in your country. As soon as you drive out of here, you drive to the Gobi Desert, it's all these beautiful, peaceful plains with animals grazing, and people living a simple life. Of course, the whole country can't go do that. We have our beautiful capital here. So here in the capital, we have to have some means by which we can become free from the stress and complicated city life. For that, we have to go back to our spiritual roots. You can't separate spirituality, you can't separate Buddhism from Mongolia. It's part of your culture. The real happiness comes from within. And by our spiritual practices, if we're happy within, through meditation, thoughtful prayer, for visiting the temples and so forth, then we can deal with the stress. It's not going to go away. We can deal with it because inside we're happy. And that's why our contribution is to give people this beautiful singing, which brings such joy to the heart. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. These names of God can create peace and joy. And one can deal with this, with the stress and anxiety. We can cooperate with that. Brothers and sisters, and spread these spiritual values together. Many hands make small work.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.